Welcome to the Kitchen Cook-Off. The rules are simple. Two chefs will face off and be judged to find out who cooks the better meal. The twist is, we'll be giving the chefs two ingredients that they will have to incorporate into their meal. The chefs will have 5 minutes to get the rest of their supplies from a local Dollar Tree. If they are not at the checkout with their supplies before the time is up, they will not be able to use those ingredients. Got it? Good. Let's go see the contestants.
Ethan Wurzberger, Max Elementary.
You know what time it is, man. Shout out to the P, we finna go win this chicken and salsa.
Yeah, I really don't know what I'm making with my chicken and salsa, but hey, I'm a chef. I'm a whip something up. I'm gonna do my job. I'm gonna make sure it tastes good. I'm gonna make sure it smells good. Hey, we're gonna win.
All right, so today for the kitchen cook-off, Pat gave us chicken and salsa. You know, I don't really know what I'm gonna cook, so I just looked up a Google recipe to make chicken and salsa tacos. So check back in with you when we get back.
All right, we're here at the local Hy-Vee with the contestants. They each have 5 minutes to get their groceries, and if they aren't at the checkout in time, they can't use them. Let's go.
I see the salsa and the chips.
My hands are full, I need a car.
I'm just shopping, yeah, just got the position. I'm gonna get some chicken burgers.
I just found a meat.
So, this I got for y'all fellas today. First of all, how y'all fellas doing today?
Good.
Yes, sir. Y'all look good. Yes, sir. But this I got today. I got buffalo chicken dip, homemade dish. You can make this dish. Put it anywhere, restaurant, events. For example, Super Bowl. Yeah, and the salsa. So, yeah, this is what I came up with. Our ingredients were chicken and salsa. And this first thing came off back of the head. Yes, sir. Hope you enjoy it.
Yeah, so I thought this dish was pretty good. I like spicy food, and this came with a lot of spice, and I think the chips added a good crunch to it. So I'd give it a solid 9 out of 10.
All right, JB. I'd like to say, first of all, out of any dish throughout this entire season, this is by far the best one that we've had so far coming to the show. I really enjoyed your dish. I felt like you could actually tell that you put some time into it and that you actually cared about what you were making, and it tastes like home cooking. So with that being said, I'm gonna give you a 9.4.
All right, so basically, I mean, it's pretty good. I mean, you can't go wrong with anything that was included in this dish. So, I mean, for that, I'm gonna give it a 8.8. I'd probably be higher, but I mean, it's not really like a very super creative, but it's fucking good, so.
Yeah, man, hey, it is what it is. Hey, I feel like my dish is a good dish. You can eat it anywhere, anytime, but hey, Libby, I knew he was gonna judge me tough, but 8.8, I'll take the highest score on the show. Come on now. Hey, I did it for the city, for the P, for Chicago.
All right, today I got chicken and I guess salsa burritos. I don't know, I just threw some stuff together, so hope you guys like it. I thought it had good flavor. You know, it was missing that crunch that I like. I'd rate it a overall 8-7.
I did enjoy this dish as well. I think both of y'all came out hot today. This is probably the best episode we've had so far. I do agree with Jensen that there was a crunch factor that was missing. But overall, I did think you did a good job incorporating the ingredients that were required. And I'm going to give you an 8-7.
All right, so this is pretty good. It's probably something I would throw together if I had no food, like, and I just had to scavenge for stuff. But it was pretty good. Like they all both said, it could have been a little crunchy. It was kind of cold a little bit. But, yeah, I'd probably give it like a 7-7-7. It wasn't bad. It's pretty good.
I agree with the judges' scores that they gave me today. Could have added a little bit more crunchy factor to it. Overall, good job, JB.